Let us see a very important law that is termed as Ohm's law. It states that under constant physical conditions, the applied potential difference across a conductor is directly proportional to current flowing in it. See, this is a, say, any conductor, current is passed through it when you apply across some potential difference across it. So what does it says? V is directly proportional to I, so V is equal to some proportionality constant mathematically, and I took it as R, right? V is equal to RI. R is termed as resistance of a conductor. Resistance of a conductor, you can define it from V over I, from the same formula. SI unit of V is volt, this is ampere, so SI unit of this is ohm, and 1 ohm is equal to 1 volt over 1 ampere. So you can define resistance of 1 ohm just form a sentence by using this mathematical relation. How do you form a sentence? The resistance of a conductor is said to be of 1 ohm when 1 ampere current flows through a conductor against a potential difference of 1 volt. I repeat, resistance of a conductor is said to be 1 ohm when 1 ampere current flows through a conductor against a potential difference of 1 volt. When we plot a VI graph, it comes straight line. And this graph must pass through the origin, because V is equal to RI is equation of format y is equal to mx. So this is a slope. Slope of graph, that is m is equal to tan theta, will measure the value of resistance. So small conceptual questions are also formed on it, like in a graph, in a VI graph of two conductors, A and B, is shown. Which conductor has larger resistance? So if I plot a graph like this, let's change the axis and create little confusion. A and B, which has more resistance? B. RB of B is more than RA, because remember, slope is measured from current axis, and now I wrote current and y axis, so you will measure angle from here, theta 1, theta 2, theta 2. Angle theta 2 is greater than theta 1. So slope of B curve is more than the slope of curve A. Therefore, the resistance of conductor B will be more than the conductor A. Now, suppose you want to justify it experimentally. So make connection. For experimental verification, make connection. Resistance, choose any resistance of unknown value. Connect emitter always in series. EMF source or cell. Since you have a battery, whatever you want, but since you have to change the potential, so use rheostat. And one connection of rheostat, you bring it back here. Right? Now you need voltmeter to measure potential difference, so connect voltmeter across this resistance. Start changing the value of rheostat. This rider you can move forward and backward. The value of current will change in the conductor, and accordingly the voltage will change. So you can take a set of 5 readings, say serial number, voltage, and then current. Say 1, when voltage is 0, it is 0. When it is 2, it is 4. When it is 3, then voltage is 6. When it is 4, voltage is, current is 8. When it is 5, then voltage, current becomes 10. Now plot a graph. Easy. V is taken here, so 0 or 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right? Current is taken here. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Just take an equal interval of time. So when this is 0, voltage, current is 0. When it is 2, current is 4. When it is 3, current is 6. When it is 4, current is 8. When it is 5, current is 10. Mark and join all these points. You will get a straight line. Even if you don't have any reading, then straight away from the graph you measure an angle and then find the value of tan theta, you will get answer for resistance of a conductor. We discussed right now about resistance. What is resistance? Now I am going about resistance in detail. It is an opposition offered by a conductor to the flow of electrons through it. Now question arises, how does a conductor offer a position? Conductor is not a human being. If somebody is trying to move and I have to stop this person to move, then I push backward and apply some force on it. It's a non-living object. So how come it offers resistance? What actually happens when electrons move through a metallic conductor? Metallic conductor is a solid. Suppose this is a positive point, this is negative, electron will drift from negative to the positive inside the conductor, and its structure inside the conductor is very compact. Compact means atoms or molecules are placed very close to each other. So the moment electron is accelerating by an electric field, it immediately collides with a neighbor molecule. Once it collides, it loses velocity as well as kinetic energy. So it slows down and further accelerated and then moves ahead, and then again collision occurs. So I mean to say, by the time when electron moves from negative end towards the positive end, an electron, a single electron, suffers with multiple collisions inside the conductor with atoms. So this is an obstruction. That's how the structure, solid structure of the metallic conductor offers opposition. That is called resistance. Resistance of a conductor is directly proportional to the length of conductor and inversely proportional to area of cross section. Right? So when you remove proportionality sign, you have to bring some equality sign and then some constant. So rho is another constant brought here. This rho is called resistivity. So resistivity you can define from here. Resistivity rho is equal to Ra over L. SI unit, or you can easily count resistance, SI unit is ohm, meter square over meter, that is ohm, meter is SI unit of resistivity. If you want to define it mathematically, then put if L of a conductor is 1 meter and area of cross section is 1 meter square, this implies the rho is equal to R. So now you can again form a sentence and define resistivity. So what is resistivity? Form a sentence. It is a resistivity of the material of conductor. Resistivity of the material of a conductor is numerically equal to the resistance of a conductor of unit length and unit area of cross section. I repeat, resistivity of metallic conductor or material of a conductor is defined as numerically equal to the resistance of a conductor of unit length and unit area of cross section. Remember, resistivity does not depend on physical dimension. Number one, independent of physical dimensions, independent of physical dimensions of conductors. Physical dimensions means what? Length, breadth, area of cross section, it does not depend. It is absolute, a property of material of conductor used. So resistivity of conductor will change only when material of conductor is changed. I mean to say, the resistivity of two wires, one is of copper, another is of aluminium, will be different. But if you take two copper wire of different length and different area of cross section, resistance will change but resistivity will remain same. Another factor which also influences resistivity is temperature. So with the rise in temperature, the resistivity of temperature increases, resistivity of material increases. So I repeat, with rise in temperature, resistivity of material increases. So if we look at the expression of the resistance, however there is no temperature is appearing in the expression, nowhere temperature is appearing in the expression, but it's still, whether sometimes you like it or not, it happens. So it is happening with the resistance too. Since resistance depends on resistivity and resistivity depends on temperature, therefore resistance of metallic conductor also depends on temperature. Clear? Now I am classification of material on the basis of Ohm's law. Number one are termed as ohmic, materials or ohmic devices. Materials which obey Ohm's law exactly. Materials which obey Ohm's law. Ohm's law are called ohmic materials, like any metallic conductor is ohmic. So if we plot VI graph of ohmic devices, it will always be a straight line. Right? Another type of the devices are non-ohmic. Second type of devices are non-ohmic. But it is very unfortunate that maximum number of the devices which we are using in day-to-day life are non-ohmic devices. They do not obey Ohm's law. The material or materials which do not obey Ohm's law are called non-ohmic devices or non-ohmic materials. This is a time where we are using semiconductor devices, digital devices. For semiconductors, these are not obeying Ohm's law. For such devices or materials, they never have VI characteristics as a straight line. I am plotting a graph VI characteristics for PN junction. It goes like this. This is semiconductor PN junction diode. If we plot a graph between for liquid electrolyte, between I and V, this graph will also appear as. If we plot a graph for semiconductor mixed device gallium arsenide, the graph is little weird. So from here O2A, it is obeying Ohm's law. O2B, you see, when current potential is increasing, current is decreasing, so it gives a special feature. A to B portion, we call it as negative resistance region. This is a special characteristic shown by gallium arsenide material, where we can see negative resistance. What happens in negative resistance region? When potential difference is increasing, current is decreasing. However, according to the Ohm's law, it is directly proportional. Let's see now two questions. A wire of resistance 5 ohm and length 15 meter has area of cross section 16 × 10⁻⁷ m². What is the resistivity of the material? So to find solution, write formula rho is equal to Ra over L. Everything is given. R is 5 this area of cross section 10 to minus 7 divided by L is 15 meter. So this is 3 ja 2 into 10 raised to the power minus 7 ohm meter. Yes. Simple answer. There is another question. Two wires of length A and B of same material have their lengths in the ratio of 4:1. The radii with the ratio of 2:5. If the length of thicker wire is 3 ohm, if the resistance of thicker wire is 3 ohm, calculate the resistance of thin wire. So which one is thick wire? If you look at the radii of ratio 2:5, so wire B is thick wire. So use equation for resistance 2 times. Solution: RA is equal to rho A LA over A, area of cross section A. RB for same wire, rho B LB over area of cross section B. Dividing 1/2. So what you will have? RA over RB. Rho A, rho AB cancel because material is same. So it is LA over LB, AB over AA. Now put up the ratio. LA over LB is 4/1. This is 2/5. AA over AB is 2/5. So it is 5/2. But it is radii ratio. So you will put the area value also here. Pi RB square over pi RA square. Pi cancel. So it is 4/1. RB means 4 and 4 cancels. So RA over RB is equal to 25. This implies RA is equal to 25 RB. RB is given 3 ohm. So RA is equal to 25 into 3, that is 75 ohm. Simple exercise. Let's do little more conceptual questions in it that will really work it out well. A copper wire of length 10 centimeter has resistance 10 ohm. What will be its resistance and resistivity if number A, part A, length is doubled, B, length is doubled, by stretching a wire. You may be thinking, what is difference in this question A and B part of the question? In any case, length is doubled by stretching, so the resistance will directly be affected in the same manner. Let's see, is it really going to give impact in the same manner? Solution: from formula R is equal to rho L over A, resistance is directly proportional to L. So this is original situation. New resistance R dash is equal to rho L dash over A dash. Equation 2. So R dash over R is equal to L dash over L and then A over A dash. Now when you are in question, it is only given length is doubled. It means area of cross section is not changed. This ratio remains same. So length is doubled means L dash is 2L over L. L gets cancelled. So R dash will be equal to 2R. And here is the resistance 10 ohm. So it is 20 ohm. Now question lies there only. By stretching the length of a wire to a double, how does it matter? This is a wire. When you stretch this wire of length L into a double length, so you have made it length equal to 2L. So by stretching, when you are doing it, its area of cross section is also reducing. What remains constant? Volume. So volume V, first area of cross section, then second area of cross section into length, that is A1 first length is L, A2 first length is 2L, L cancels, so new area of cross section is A1 by 2. So area of cross section becomes half. Going back to the same formula, R dash over R, L dash over L, A over A dash. Right, that is A1 is A, A2 is A dash. So you can put a value here, L dash is 2L over L, A is A1 and this A dash is A1 by 2, so A by 2, L cancel, A cancel, so this is 4, R dash is equal to 4R. Now the resistance will be 4 into R is how much? 10. So it is 40 ohm. Just have a look. The resistance by stretching becomes 40. However, if you are just increasing the length, it becomes a twice. So you have to keep sight on a question. Whether this length is increased by doubling the length of the wire. I mean to say by adding another wire of the same material of the same length, then this answer is true. While you are increasing length of the same wire by stretching it, your answer comes out to be 40. So in general you can say, suppose in general if length is stressed, to n times of original length, then new resistance will be equal to n square over old resistance. I mean to say, in the same question, instead of saying twice double of the length by stretching, if I make it three times by stretching, so n is equal to 3, the resistance goes 9 times. If we make it 4 times to the original length, then n is equal to 4, it goes 16 times. Another thing is resistivity. There will be no effect on resistivity because resistivity is absolutely a characteristic of the material. It does not depend on the physical dimension. So while you are changing, increasing length, decreasing length, increasing area of cross section, compressing area of cross section of the wire, it hardly matters to the resistivity of material wire or material. So resistivity will change only by changing material.